topic of our today's lecture is blood diseases. First of all, I want to remember you that our blood is formed from 50-60% liquid part, which is plasma, and 40-45% blood elements, from which depended viscosity of the blood or will determine such indices of the blood analysis as hematocrit. Blood elements divided on three main groups depending their functions in our organism. And first of all, red blood cells, erythrocytes, which normal count varies from 4 to 5 times 10-12 degree per liter. Main functions of erythrocyte is transport of oxygen. Next main element is leukocyte, which count varies from 4 to 9 times 10-9 degree per liter, which main function is protection of our organism. And thrombocyte or platelet, which counts varies from 180 to 320 times 10-9 degree per liter, which main function is coagulative control to prevent bleeding. Leukocytes divided on some element which always has specific function. And first of all leukocytes, depending the structure, divided on two groups, agranulocyte and granulocyte, with or without nucleus. Granulocytes divided on basophils, eosinophils, and neutrophils. Basophils and eosinophils, first of all, responds on any allergic process. Neutrophils are main elements with protective response, which first of all responds on any inflammatory or toxic process in our organism. And depending structure of nucleus, neutrophils divided on step and segmented. Agranulocytes divided on two groups, lymphocytes and monocytes, which indicates about our immune response, activity of immune system, and the level increases or decreases depending activity of our immune system. All diseases of blood system, depending on the main elements, also may be divided on three groups. Anemia, diseases which appear due to decreased activity of erythrocytes and they count in our organism. Hemoblastosis, first of all, affected white blood cells. And hemorrhagic diathesis, which first of all appears due to decreased activity platelets or thrombocytes. Today we'll stop on fourth group of blood diseases, anemia. Anemia is pathology which is characterized with decreased level of hemoglobin and in blood and erythrocyte count. Lexium. What is cause of anemia? First of all, we distinguish three main pathological processes which accompanied with anemia. It is loss of blood when the protective response of bone marrow not enough to compensate loss of red blood cells. other problem, which is disordered hemopoiesis. When the process formation of erythrocyte disturbed due to deficiency of some vitamins and microelements. And other cause is excessive hemolysis when the process destruction of erythrocytes not correlated with process the formation. And in all cases, in peripheral blood will be decreased level of hemoglobin and decreased amount of erythrocyte. You can compare health and patient with anemia. Anemia due to loss of blood divided also on some groups. And first of all, it is acute or chronic post-hemorrhagic anemia. Anemia due to disordered hemopoiesis. There are iron deficiency anemia. When production of hemoglobin disturbed. And vitamin B12 deficiency anemia. When will be disturbed process maturation of erythrocyte or normal erythropoiesis. And we must remember about primary problem with bone marrow, inhibition function of bone marrow due to endogenous or exogenous toxicosis, due to pathological effect of ionic radiation, or due to replacement of the red bone marrow by myeloma or multiply metastasis. Other words, we are talking about hypo or aplastic anemia and secondary anemia due to depression of the red bone marrow. And last group, anemia due to excessive hemolysis or hemolytic anemia. I said you, it appears due to intensification of destructive process when process destruction of erythrocytes not correlated with the synthesis. In clinical practice, we often meet with mixed anemia, maybe combined iron and B12 deficiency anemia, B12 and hemolytic anemia. When we are talking about anemia, we must distinguish anemia depending on Kalle index, or other words, it is saturation of erythrocytes with hemoglobin. And if the level of saturation of hemoglobin enough, we are talking about normochromic anemia, which determined depending on Kalle index. And you see normal Kalle index deviates from 0.85 to 1.15. If the process saturation erythrocytes with hemoglobin decreases, we are talking about hypochromic anemia. Kalle index becomes less than 0.85. And opposite process, oversaturation hypochromic anemia, when the Kalle index becomes